So let's take a look at the code. We have a for loop. Now, within the for loop, there's always three sections, right? The first section is for the initial value of the counter. So in this case, let me use variable x as a counter, and I initialize it with 0. Now, the condition, the second section will be condition to stop. In this case, the condition to stop will be 1. It'll be 1, yeah? And then the third section will be increment. Now, you see there's an error here because I haven't declared what x is. So compiler says, I don't know what is x. So at line 4, I will declare x as integer. Yes, you can.
In the main bracket.
You can do that. But if you do like this, the x will only be recognized inside the body of for loop. It is the same. But if you plan to use the x again, then you declare outside. Yeah? Okay? Now, can anyone tell me what this code is doing? It will display on the screen repetition followed by the number. The number is the value inside x, right? And then each time it will show in a new line. Now, let's look at the code, the output of the code. Now, how do we come to this value? So we begin, this is how you read a for loop. First, you look at the counter, x. It starts with 0. Please follow me. Then, check, is x less than 1 or equal to 1? Is it less or equal to 1? If yes, you go inside the body. If no, forget about it. Skip. First round, yeah? So yes, see out repetition, the value of x is 0, yeah? Currently it's 0. So, end line. And then where does it go to? End of the for loop, right? So you cannot end yet because the condition says the condition is not right, has not ripened for ending it. So it goes to increment. It goes to update. Update doesn't necessarily increase it, yeah? It can be decrement also. Multiplication, any operation is possible. And it doesn't necessarily have to be x, it can be another variable, possible. Yeah? But of course it doesn't make sense if I update another variable. This will become an infinite loop. So I have to update x. So what will happen to x now? It becomes 1. When it becomes 1, before it executes, it will check. Every time before executing the body, it will check. It go to the middle section and check first. So is it less or equal to 1? Yes. See our repetition? 1. End line, reach end of the for loop. Update 1 becomes 2 now. Check the condition, not true anymore. So skip the loop. So if you see, the flow will be from the very beginning, line 4, initialize the counter, check, body, update, check, body, Update check body, update check body. So do you see how it flows? Initialization only occurs once. And before you execute the body, must always check. Yeah? Now let's ask, look at another example. Now suppose that I start with 10, and as long as it is greater than 1, this time I have to decrement it, right? If not, it will never reduce. It always check first, and the condition is not true, so it will just kick the whole loop without even bothering about updating it, because the condition is not right already, so it kicks the whole thing. Now let me modify it some more. Right. So I'm processing in negative values. Alright. So it also works for negative, but you must make sure the condition is correct. If not, it becomes an infinite loop. Now, does it every time has to increment or decrement by 1? Not necessary, yeah? I can reduce by 2 every time. This is equivalent to what? Be careful, this is not right. This should be like this, yeah? This is equivalent to x equal to x minus 2. Yeah? So it will reduce by 2 every time. You see? The number of loop is less now because it starts with negative 2. It's still greater than negative 10. And if display negative 2, update minus 2 becomes negative 4, and then it will repeat, it will display repetition negative 4, and it will update by deducting another negative 2, deducting another 2, becomes negative 6, so on and so forth, until it becomes negative 12, where it's no longer correct, it jumps out of the loop to line number 8 and line number 9. That's what happens. Yeah, question.
So can we use x equal to x minus
2? Can we use x equal to?
X minus 2.
Yes, you can. Yes, we can do it that way. Any valid expression will work. Yeah? Any valid expression? Now, this time, I'm going to introduce two variables. Okay, so I'm going to introduce two variables. And I'll start with one. Okay, I initialize x as 1 here, and y as 10. Now, as long as x is less than y, the condition is as long as x is less than y, because x is 1, y is 10, so x is less than y is correct. So x will increment by 1 every time. X will increment 1 every time. So I will update the content. I'm going to introduce one point minus minus, yeah? Okay, so what I'm going to do here, I'm having two variables, x and y.
Yes.
X I will increase, y I will reduce. Yeah? Every time it reduces by one. Minus minus means one. So let's execute and see what happens. Okay, can anyone tell me what's wrong? You see, because there's one variable here, x, and another variable, x, inside the for loop. So, two x variables, right? So, you understand what's going on here? You see, you said they follow the three sections. X is 1, y is 10, right? And we're using x as a counter. Using x as a counter, as long as x is less than y, we will loop it. And then when we loop it, we will display the content of x and y. And before we go to the next round, we'll update x and y. X will increase, y will minus. And then we will always check before executing the body. After update, before executing the body, must check first. As long as before executing the body, check. So you see, x increase, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, y will reduce. Until a point where x is no longer greater than, as x is no longer smaller than y. When x is equal to y, it's no longer smaller than y. So the condition is false, it jumps out from the loop to line 9. right?